गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर कीपिंग वेल. सो डियर चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द पोएम अ हाउस अ होम रिटन बाय लॉरेन एम हॉली. बिफोर आई स्टार्ट एक्सप्लेनिंग द पोएम, आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू अबाउट द पोएट. लॉरेन एम हॉली इज एन अमेरिकन पोएट बोर्न ऑन December 8, 1921. Her writing style is simple, yet thought-provoking. In this poem, she aims to make a clear distinction between a house and a home. Dear students, just focus on the title of this poem, A House, A Home. Normally, these two words, house and home, are synonyms. But through this poem, the poet is explaining or the poet is telling the difference between a house and a home. If somebody asks you, can you tell the difference between a house and a home? I think so, you can't tell. But when we will finish this poem, you will come to know. So here we start the poem. What is a house? It's brick and stone and wood that's hard, some window glass and perhaps a yard. It's eaves and chimneys and tile floors and stucco and roof and lots of doors. But before I start explaining the poem, I would like to share some meanings of difficult words which will help you understand the poem in a better way. Okay, so first I will explain the meaning of some difficult words. Let's have a look. So the first word is yard. Yard means an open space. It can be at the front of or the back of the house, or it can be used for gardening or for any other purpose. Eaves. Eaves means the part of the roof that hangs out over the walls to provide shade. Stucco, fine paint. Chimneys, a pipe which takes smoke or combustion gases up from the fire. And normally, chimneys are there in the kitchen of any house. Okay, so now we start the poem. What is a house? It's brick and stone and wood that's hard, some window glass and perhaps a yard. The poem begins with a question. The poet asks a question. What is a house? In next line, the poet explains the material which is used to make a house. The poet says that bricks, stone and wood are those material which are used to make a house. It also has window glass and corridors or open space in front and back of the house, which can be used for gardening. It's eaves and chimneys and tile floors and stucco and roof and lots of doors. Tiles of the floors, fine paints, roof, elevation of the roof and many doors that give it a perfect look of a house. So in short, we can say a house is made up of non-living things, or we can say it is a construction only. Okay students, I hope it is clear to you. The meaning of this stanza is clear to you. So dear student, now I am going to tell you the rhyming words which are used in this stanza. As you know, rhyming words are used in any poem to give it a musical touch. And normally these words come at the end of any sentence. So let's find out the rhyming words. So first look at the word, last words of each line. House, stone, hard, glass, yard, chimneys, floors, roof, doors. So you can easily find out the words, rhyming words. So in this stanza, two pair of rhyming words are there. First one is floors and doors. And the second one is hard and yard. So in this stanza, two pair of rhyming words are there. Which one? Hard and yard, floors and doors. Okay. So dear children, for today, this much is sufficient for you. You will read this stanza, you will understand it, and you will learn the word meaning. Okay. I will share the pick of word meanings also. You can write down in your book only. So next stanza, I am going to explain tomorrow. Till then, stay at home, read this poem and learn the word meanings. Okay. Tomorrow, we will complete the poem. Thank you and have a nice day.